Welcome to this edition of Titan News. I'm Monica.
And I'm James Myers.
We have some sports news for you today, including boys and girls basketball.
Also, a special report covering Lorain High's wrestling team.
Stay with us as Titan News starts right now.
Take every single piece of the blame if you want me to. But you know that there is no innocent one in this game for two. I go, and then you go out and spill the truth.
Can we both say the words and forget this?
Yeah. Is it too late now to say sorry? 'Cause I'm missing more than just your body. Back on me,
no.
'Cause I'm missing more than just your body. Is it too late now to say sorry?
On November 30th, the Lady Titans basketball team faced the North Olmsted Eagles here at Lorain High. North Olmsted outlasted Lorain for a 34-24 win in a defensive battle with a halftime score of 14-10. The Eagles fended off two Titan rallies. Lorain junior Tremia Bloyer scored 6 of her team high 7 points in the second half. Freshman Norma Janae Bohannon finished with 6, including the Titans' only 3-pointer. Coach Feldman said his players created scoring opportunities and took reasonable shots, but couldn't get them to fall. Come out and support your Lady Titans at their next home game on December 9th versus Elyria.
On Tuesday, December 1st, the boys' basketball team started the season with a high-scoring win versus John Marshall. Back-to-back high-flying dunks by Nas Bohannon and Anthony Smothers to start the game set the tone, excited the Lorain faithful. Smothers was one of 3 players to score in the double digits as he strung together a double-double with 26 points and 12 rebounds. Bohannon and a game-high 27 points and Jaleel Little scored 18. 5 other players were part of the scoring effort for the Titans. Lorain had the magic touch in the first quarter to help expand its lead to 28-9 over John Marshall, courtesy of shooting 12 of 21 from the floor, including multiple buckets coming in the paint. Little propelled the Titans with 10 first quarter points. Lorain started the second quarter on a 14-4 run and led 42-13 with 3 minutes and 45 seconds left in the half, courtesy of a Bohannon layup. The Titans led 51-25 at the intermission. Lorain scored John Marshall 17-13 in the third quarter and outscored them 33-15 in the fourth quarter to help eclipse the century mark. Deshaun Brooks scored the layup with 28 seconds left in the game to ultimately give Lorain 101 points. Lorain was not only the offensively sound, but played well defensively, forcing 30 John Marshall turnovers.
On December 4th, the boys' basketball team traveled to Vermillion. They improved to 2-0 with another impressive win. This time with a score of 92-40, Naz Bohannon came off a 27-point night Tuesday against John Marshall to post a game high 20 points and 8 rebounds. Davier Andrews had 19 points. Jaleel Little had 14, and Anthony Smothers battled foul trouble for 11th, and Kevin Davis and Jamar Ross had 10 each.
The boys' next home game will be versus Shaw in an LEL conference matchup. Come out and support Titans basketball.
Some really good Titans out there.
Yeah.
The Ray High's Career Technical Education Department recently held their annual recruiting days. Freshmen and sophomore students had their opportunity to tour the current career tech labs and talk with the teachers and students about what they do in class. The freshmen and sophomores are then given an opportunity to apply to the programs. Scheduling for next year is coming fast. Career Tech offers a variety of course options for students interested in entering the world of work immediately upon graduation, or entering college at the time to further develop the workforce skills learned in high school. Courses in Career Tech are easy designed to teach students the practical knowledge, skills, and attitude necessary to function successfully on the job site and the academic knowledge and skill necessary to enter college and succeed in college classes. The Career Tech teachers are looking forward to moving to the new labs and the new building.
Lorain High Wrestling is starting their season. Here is a report from Titan News' Ian Martinez.
Lorain has a solid core of returning wrestlers, led by two-time state placer Devin Edwards. Devin placed third in weight class 106 in 2014 and fifth as 106 last year. Also back for the Titans are state alternate and two-time district qualifier Brandon Bartlamy, two-time district qualifier Seth Klima, and district qualifier Andre Torres.
Well, you know, everyone wants to make it that trip to Columbus at the end of the year, so that's the main goal. You know, work hard, get better every day up here. You know, got to make weight first, too. These guys need to push themselves. Got to be, want to be leaders this year, you know. Maybe take this team to another level that's never been to.
Yeah. And we got the Holiday Classic coming up. Everybody wants to place at that as home. So that would be big, too.
You know, we always like heads. Everyone wants to take down a heads kid. Amherst is always a rival. Lyria messes up last year. We're hungry. We want them back this year. So, you know, we're working hard for that.
I arrived with Noah Boffman from Wadsworth. Yeah, he beat me last year. So, yeah, there's a couple kids up here. My little cousin comes up here actually. He'll be pretty good. And then, there's a couple good kids up here.
So we got a new 113 pounder, 120 pounder. He's working hard, he's improving. We got Aaron Huff, you know, he's here to work every day.
Yeah, and Khalil too.
Yeah, Khalil Brown. A lot of kids up here like to work, and that's what we need up here, inspire kids.
The Titans has beefed up their schedule since Mark Mose, a two-time state champion at St. Edward's, took over the program 3 years ago, and they advanced to the Division I regional semifinal in the dual team tournament last season. Good luck to the Titans as they start their season. This is Ian Martinez, reporting for Titan News.
Thanks, Ian. Since Ian filed that report, the Titan wrestlers competed in the Nationwide Kickoff Classic held here at Lorain High School. Congratulations to the wrestlers as they were champions of the tournament, clinching it on to the final match with a win by Sadi Santana. Also leading the way were Devin Edwards and Aaron Huff. Good job, Titans.
Well, that's all we have for this edition of Titan News. I'm James Myers.
And I'm Monica. For all of us here at Titan News, have a great day. See you next time.